also to relax him completely. Okay, so we are in shortage of pillow because exam is going on there. So only one pillow here. Okay, so one pillow for the head if required, and one pillow definitely below the knees. Okay,
to relax
him first. Okay, and then you need to give him instructions. Okay, patient should be in a comfortable position and patient should be encouraged to relax his upper chest. Okay, so we have to tell them, see, you are using your upper chest too much. Okay, so I'll be telling you a technique by which you have to relax your upper chest. Okay, so instruction is very important in this technique again. Okay, so you need to instruct the patient very properly. Receiving the patient is very important, that all you know and you have to do. Okay, so what we can do is we can either ask the patient, okay, to take one hand and keep on his tummy and you reinforce with your hand. This is one technique. Okay, the other technique is the therapist alone keeping the hand. Okay, and the home exercise program is one hand here and one hand here. Okay, and ask the patient, take in breath through your nose. Okay, this is the instruction that you give. Take in breath through your nose, and when you are breathing out, turn your face that side and purse your lip like this, and then breathe it out. In this process, when you are taking in breath, it will be an active process. While you are exhaling, it will be a passive process. You are not going to force yourself and exhale. Okay, you understood? Okay, so take in a deep breath. Hava inside. Turn your face that side and breathe it out. Okay, purse your lip, Shabab. Purse. Can you come a little bit up? Is it okay? Just go back. Is it okay? Okay. Just bend your knees. Okay? No, just keep one hand. For now, just keep one hand. So take in a deep breath. When breathing out, breathe out through your mouth passively and purse your lip. No, this is wrong. What he is doing is wrong. Not through the mouth. The main aim of this technique is breathe through the nose. Why through the nose? Yes, one is filtration. Second thing is humidification. Okay. The process through nose, when the person is breathing through the nose, the warm air, the air will get in contact with the warm epithelial lining of the nose. Okay, so what will happen? There will be process of humidification. The air that is going inside through the nose will not be dry. Okay, will be moist and warm. Okay, that will aid further relaxation. Okay, so you should encourage the breathing through the nose. Okay. So take in breath through your nose. Yes. Slowly. Don't go that fast, okay? So you have to give them instructions. If they are going very fast, you have to tell them. See, the process is very slow. See me. Okay? First, take in breath. When you're taking in breath, your tummy should come out. See, my tummy has come out. Okay? And then turn your face this side. Expiration is very slow, passive and long. Okay, what you are doing is no, that is wrong. Okay, so yeah, it has to be very slow process. Aim is to induce relaxation. Okay, bring their respiratory rate down. Take in deep breath through your nose. You have any breathing problem? Any problem you have? Any? Sure? Okay. Take a deep breath. Yes. His tummy is coming out. Good. Yes. Okay. So take in. Yeah, very good. Very good. Excellent. You are actually breathing through your chest. Okay, so in him, he is a perfect patient. Okay, so once you are breathing in, your tummy should come up. Okay, my this hand should go up first. This hand should go up later. Okay, so take in a deep breath. Yes, good. Then out. Okay. So his tummy should come out first. Okay. So instruction should be, when you are taking in air, you should feel your tummy coming out. Okay.
Why are the hand for the patient?
Hand is for a feedback. Okay. So I am not sure that he is breathing through abdomen. He is using more of his chest. So I am keeping hand as a feedback for him and as well for me, that he should breathe in a correct way. Okay. So very important is the pattern of breathing. The pattern of normal breathing is abdominothoracic. That means when we breathe in, the abdomen comes out first, followed by chest. If in some people we are seeing chest is coming out first, that means the pattern of breathing is wrong. They might be smoking too much. This could be one reason. How many pack a day you smoke? Three packs, four packs, ten. One pack. Ten cigarettes. So one pack a day he smokes. How many cigarettes are there in a pack?
20.
Okay. So same way you should answer in your Viva also. Okay. Okay, so again, try to take in deep breath, okay, and then purse your lip and breathe it out, okay. Why I'm asking him to turn the face that side?
Because the thorax.
Because he might be infected, he's a patient, okay. He might be having pneumonia, he might be having post-tuberculosis patient, okay, post-infection patient. If he breathes on my face, that's all, khalas, I'll be lying beside him, okay, I'll get infected, okay. So take in a deep breath. And then, okay, so now he started using his abdominal muscles. Good. Again, take a deep breath. Very good. Good, okay. So now he is having a correct way of breathing. Before he was breathing through chest. Okay. Now he started breathing through abdomen. So once he is taking in air, you should feel the abdomen rising. Okay, so that's the thing. Okay, once he's breathing out, you should feel the abdomen going down. If in case he's pressing it like this and pushing the air out, you have to tell him, please don't do that. Okay, it has to be completely passive process. Okay, passive, you understand?
Passive.
It has to happen on its own. Okay, he doesn't have to push the lung for air to move out. Okay. Okay, so as the patient breathes in, the hand should move out. Okay, that's what I have been telling you. Patient breathes out, the hand sinks down in again. Okay, the patient, when the patient is exhaling, hand is again going down. Okay, so movement of hand is a feedback. So once you're teaching him home exercise program, what you have to do is, okay, ask him to keep one hand here, other hand here, okay, and ask him to do, perform relaxed diaphragmatic breathing, okay. So why we are keeping this hand? For feedback purpose, okay. So that he gets a feedback that the tummy is coming out, then tummy is going in. His chest should not come out first, okay. That means he is using a lot of accessory muscles. That's not good, okay. So we use it for feedback, okay. Now again take a deep breath. See now, tummy is moving more. Okay, breathe it out slowly, slowly, very slow. Slowly, okay. Slowly. Okay. So now his movement of abdomen is more. Okay, we can clearly see in the demonstration.
Okay, one of this.
Abdomen should come out first, because our way of pattern of breathing is, normal pattern of breathing is abdominothoracic. That means abdomen comes out first, followed by thoracic. Okay, so we are giving them a deep training so that the respiratory center muscles, they get altered and they start recruiting the muscles in the normal way. Okay, so it's like a neurological feedback the patient is having. Okay, so now you can come and practice.